There have been 11 peer-reviewed articles about what meat production is going to look like in 2050. The lowest prediction is 62% more. One of the predictions is three times as much. They generally hover at about double. So you think about the fact that right now, more than 75% of agricultural land use is to either grow crops to feed the chickens and pigs or to graze ruminants. It's 3 billion hectares of land right now that is used for terrestrial animal production. That's the size of China plus India times two plus Indonesia. 11 peer-reviewed articles basically hover around double that in 2050. That is going to be horrible for pastoralists. That's going to be horrible for subsistence farmers in developing economies. As Chris just said, the same sort of relationship is existing with aquaculture and commercial fishing, which is also going way, way up with all of the harms that he just indicated. So we can talk about things like antimicrobial resistance and climate change and biodiversity. The global populations that contributed to the least to these problems are the ones who are most adversely impacted. So when we're thinking at GFI, at the Good Food Institute, about systemic solutions, we realize that even in the United States, where understanding of the external costs of meat production are as developed as they are anywhere in the world, per capita meat consumption, the five highest years for per capita meat consumption in the United States are the most recent five. So for people in this room, that's oftentimes shocking. People who are like tuned in with food and they're like, wait, but there are vegan options everywhere. According to the USDA, the five highest years for per capita are the most recent five. So we need systemic solutions. And at GFI, we think, you know, let's make meat with plants. Let's cultivate meat with cells. Let's give consumers exactly what they want. Let's undercut on price. So just like renewable energy, the idea is to replace fossil fuels with renewables, just like the idea of electric vehicles is to replace gas-powered cars with electric. We can win in the marketplace with alternative proteins, and we think that's a big part of the solution.